The best Samsung phone that you are not buying. When Samsung first launched this particular phone, my original decision was to skip it because $1,000 is a lot of money and it was better to save your kidneys. Even though at the end of the year, this phone was the best overall phone of 2017. Back then was a different game, but now, oh boy, now things are changed and somewhat alarming for Samsung. You see, the best phone for Samsung right now is the Galaxy S9 Plus, but is it really the best? And I include the Note 9 in this as well because thanks to our extensive research in the leaks and rumors, we know that the Note 9 is almost similar to the Note 8. Like, there is no major visual difference at all, which makes the Galaxy Note 8 so good, and I mean so good, that according to one of the leaksters, he says that Samsung might actually discontinue the Note 8 because it's so good, the features and everything, that it might actually cannibalize the sales for the Note 9. And that's why Samsung, for the first time, is thinking about discontinuing a flagship from the last year. You see, the story was much different with the Galaxy S8 and S8 Plus. We had the same infinity design, but there were no dual cameras, which was a big deal. But with the Note 8, we already have the dual cameras and lots of other features, which make things alarming for Samsung when it comes to the upcoming Note 9 sales. I've been using this phone for about a year now. I was one of the early adopters of this phone, so it was the best of 2017, but where does it stand in 2018, and why it's the best Samsung phone to go for right now. Now, first up is design, and well, what can I say? This is not only premium, but also super relevant in 2018. It is almost similar to the Galaxy Note 9, which is one of the reasons why Samsung might actually be discontinuing this amazing phone. The only difference that you're gonna see between the Note 8 and the Note 9 is going to be that fingerprint scanner, which is now at a much better position on the Note 9. Below the camera sensors, while this one has the fingerprint scanner right next to the camera, and I admit this is one of the worst positions for a fingerprint scanner to be at. I mean, right out of the box, it will be a pain in the ass. But after a year of usage, it's actually not that bad, and I can pretty much use it almost every single time when I want to unlock my phone. So it's a good thing that this design flaw is fixed on the Note 9, but it's not something of a major significance, which is why this is still one of the best smartphone design in 2018. It does have a single speaker at the bottom, which is definitely not as good as the Galaxy S9 Plus, but still, it is the best single speaker performance on any Samsung phone. Moving on to the display, this is still having one of the best OLED smartphone display you can have on any phone. We know that Samsung is the best when it comes to the OLED technology, and the best part is that there is no notch on this phone, which is why I think it's still the best bezel-less execution out there right now. Obviously, in my usage, I did crack it. I dropped it a couple of times, so I have a crack at the top corner. With my second Samsung Galaxy Note 8, I was a lot of which is why I would recommend a case, but overall, this is an amazing display with amazing bezels ratio, and again, this is going to be as relevant as its design in 2018 because the bezels are actually going to be the same as the Note 9, so pretty much there is no design change coming with the design or the display, which makes this phone still a super worthy phone to go for. Now, let's talk about the performance, how good the Note 8 is after a year of usage. It's rocking a Snapdragon 835 processor, and if it was 2014 or 2013, I would have said that yes, the Samsung phone is lagging because of its TouchWiz software, but this is 2018, and Samsung has changed a lot. They have changed their software game, the Experience UI is much better with the animations and speed, and overall, the stability is much better compared to the older versions, and the Snapdragon 835 is still a pretty fast chipset. The Note 8, if you guys remember, is one of the first phones, is actually the first phone from Samsung to have a 6GB of RAM, so it's pretty good with the RAM management. We've done a bunch of different speed tests with the Galaxy S9 family, and you guys have seen that the differences in real life is not noticeable. Although Snapdragon 845 is the latest hardware, but it is definitely not the greatest. I mean, it is better when it comes to benchmarks, but you won't be able to see the differences when it comes to the real life performance. Which is why I still love my Galaxy Note 8 because its performance is so damn good, even after a year of usage. This is the Exynos model, and I am including the Qualcomm variant as well. Both these two models have great performance, and on Android 8.0 Oreo, things were even better. All right, now let's talk about the cameras. Now, the Note 8 comes with dual cameras, and this was not something that was present on the S8 family, and it was a big deal. I mean, having a live focus feature where you are taking pictures like this is pretty incredible. And nowadays, I won't ever use a phone without the ability to have live focus or portrait mode. I mean, it's becoming such an important feature that pretty much every phone has it, but there are very few phones that are good at it. And the Note 8 is thankfully one of the few phones on the market that has one of the best portrait mode / live focus mode performance. I've taken some stunning images, and you might be thinking how good this camera system is in 2018. With the S9 family, Samsung introduced the wearable aperture dual camera system, which is going to be the same on the Note 9 as well. And in comparison to that, the Note 8 is still a pretty good camera. Like, it's hard to see major differences outdoor, and unless you're shooting in super low light conditions, you won't be able to see much difference. I mean, yes, the processing is better. We have 4K 60 frames per second, as well as the super slow-mo feature, which is pretty dope, but not something that I would say considered to be upgrade worthy. So the Note 8 camera is, in my opinion, still one of the best. It has the ability to shoot amazing ultra HD video at 30 frames per second with dual pixel autofocus, which is still one of the fastest I have ever tried on a phone. And in my honest opinion, there is literally no major reason to upgrade when it comes to camera. We have the AR emoji feature with the Galaxy S9 family, and you will see it on the Note 9 as well. And to be honest, straight up, it is garbage. Like, this is something that I have never used on my S9. Like, ever since I bought this phone, I only tried it like once, and I'm trying it like the second or third time on this video right now. But literally, it is a bad feature that Samsung wants to make in order to compete with Apple. So in my honest opinion, the Note 8 camera is still one of the best for this year. Now let's talk about the battery life on this phone. Now this is where this phone is bad. Like, I'm not gonna say it sucks at battery life, but it is bad for a phone this big. I mean, Samsung clearly went with a smaller battery on this phone because they were afraid of the exploding scene that happened with the Note 7 earlier. You can still last a day of usage. If it depends how much you use this phone. I mean, for me, it barely lost a day. One of my friends who has the Galaxy Note 8, for him, the battery life is pretty good, but for me, in my personal usage, it's close to a day. So yes, if you spend more on the Galaxy S9 Plus, we're definitely going to see better battery life on the S9 Plus because of its bigger 3500 cell. Not a huge difference between these two phones. Samsung has fixed this with the Galaxy Note 9. You're now getting a 4000 mAh cell. It's definitely going to be one of the best Samsung phone when it comes to the battery life. But honestly, with the Galaxy Note 8, it is, again, not on par with the S9 Plus or the Galaxy Note 9. Definitely it's not going to be on par with that, but it is something you can live with. I mean, this phone has fast charging, and I'm not always outside, so I can charge my phone when I want to. So definitely not a deal breaker in my opinion, but something that I would say not as good as those other phones. And now let's talk about one of the best reasons to purchase this phone, which is its price. You no longer have to sell your kidneys in order to purchase the Galaxy Note 8. I mean, it's crazy that a once $1,000 phone can now be get for as cheap as $600 something. So you can grab a Galaxy Note 8 for like $600 to $700 range. There are some good deals going on, and if it's true that Samsung will discontinue it, you will see some even better deals for this amazing smartphone. And I have recommended this phone to so many people, including some of my friends. And the best part is you can save so much money, like so much money that you can later spend on something like Galaxy S9, which is definitely going to have a major design change, or even the Note 10 if you want to wait long, because this is definitely an amazing phone. And like I said, the design is very similar to the Galaxy Note 9, which is why it's going to be very relevant even in the next year till we see the Galaxy Note 10. Now, one of the biggest updates you're going to see with the Note 9 is also has to do something with the S Pen. So the S Pen is going to be thicker. It's going to have Bluetooth and all those capabilities. And right now, it does feel like some extra features. Yeah, guys, if you want to buy a Samsung phone and you don't want to miss out on any major feature, then Galaxy Note 8 is the phone to go for. Now is the best time to purchase this phone. For the price, it is definitely the best of Samsung. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comment section, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.